Hi everyone, this is Chicho. Welcome to my channel and welcome to another comic book live stream. We're doing a live stream right now. It's August 20th, I believe, Sunday. And we're going to be doing a couple of readings. And I picked out these readings because they were cute. They're fun reads. And the first one we're going to do is a silent issue. And this is one of the comic books I picked up a couple of years ago from a comic book retailer in town that was dumping like a ton of comics for 25 cents a pop. So I picked up this comic for 25 cents and it was in the boxes. I picked up a few hundred boxes of comics that I picked up, and I ended up reading this like a few days ago, and I thought it was a super cute read. Very well done artistically. Because it's a silent issue, the imagery really has to tell you the story, and it does a fantastic job telling the story. Now, this is it put out by an independent publisher called, here, let me take this out of the back so we don't get the glow out of it or on it. Okay, this is an independent publisher called, whoop, let's see if we can get this thing to focus. Their logo is pretty cute. Monkey Suit Press, right? And they put out a graphic novel of this character, of this, or of this comic book. I think it's the first one they put out, and this is issue number 2, and it's called Rover by Michael Foran, right? Foran. And I really couldn't find anything on him personally. Monkey Suit Press, the first comic they put out was in 1999, and it was literally Monkey Suit trade paperback. I don't know, there's 5 issues in it. I don't know what's there. Aside from that, they put out a handful of comics from 1999 with Monkey Suit trade paperback. And then they had a big problem with Marshall in 2002, Adventures of Maya in 2003-2004, and then they had Rex Steel Nazi Smasher graphic novel in 2004, and then Rover from 2002-2003 with issue number 1 and 2, and then Survival Machine trade paperback came out in 2003. Those are the only issues, comics, that I know that they've put out. Okay, so that's what we know of this. And one thing I liked is that the back cover, there was a bunch of reviews that were put out by different people saying, you know, the artwork is really good. It's a silent comic telling a story without words, is really interesting. So that really intrigued me. I was looking forward to reading this, and I was very pleasantly surprised. Okay, now what I'm going to do is I'm going to read this little bit to give you a little intro to this. I believe, I'm going to read this little bit. And these are the 3 main characters that we're going to come across in this title. Rover is the main character, and then we got Zep is his best friend, and supposedly, I'm assuming in issue number 1, we figured out that Fub was sort of adversary of Rover, but that doesn't really come across. We don't know what the story is of that part. Okay, now as far as the intro to this issue goes, follow Rover down into the dark caverns to help him save his new friend Zep, who has been kidnapped by the devil moles. To save him, Rover is forced into an uneasy truce with Fub, his one-time rival. Can Fub be trusted to help get Zep back? Discover the peculiar and dangerous things waiting in the deep in this charming and addictive series. And I found it sort of sad that there was only 2 issues of this comic book put out, right? Because it had huge potential. It had huge potential. Okay. This is volume number one, issue number two of Rover. That came out in 2003 by Michael Foran. Published by Monkey Suit Press. Monkey Suit Press is Pat Giles, Michael Foran, Chris McLaughlin, Miguel Martinez Joffrin, Prentice Rollins. Special thanks go out to my beautiful wife Sarah, Michael and Shannon Cobb, Enrico Casarosa, Bill Pressing, Nick DeMayo, Mom and Dad, Ellen Wood, and the fine crew at Noodle Soup Productions. Copyright 2003, Michael Foran. No part of this book may be reproduced without the expressed and written permission of Michael Foran, except for small excerpts for purposes of review. Any similarity between characters, persons, or institutions in Rover and those of any person living or dead is purely coincidental and unintentional. First printing, November 2003. Send inquiries and correspondence to Monkey Suit Press, 170 West End Avenue, Suite 30D, New York, New York, 10023. Letters to Michael Foran or Rover become the property of Michael Foran or are assumed intended for publication in whole or in part and may therefore be used for those purposes. Okay, as far as the copyright thing here, I think these guys would be super cool with us doing this reading, giving them a little bit of exposure, right, and appreciating their efforts for putting out a fantastic comic book that, as a comic book collector goes, for me, I was very, very pleasantly surprised with, right? So we're going to go quiet. This is a silent comic book, and we're just going to appreciate the artwork and the storytelling. Okay, gang? I hope you like. I thought that was a fun read. I thought that was. It's cute. It was very cute. Actually, these characters had huge potential, like the way the storytelling was going. It's unfortunate that the series only had two issues, and I don't think they've appeared again. But nice artwork. Here's Rover number one, right? And you can pick these up on the cheap. Premiere issue, right? So I might try to track this down and just get one and two together. And you can buy it on eBay fairly easily and inexpensive. In Search of Monkey Suit, and this is the graphic novel they put out. I think the first story that they put out. Very cool, very cool. Just to read these guys, just the reviews. The pages are triumphs of comic format. The complex structure makes reading worthwhile, the more so because it's more complicated to describe than it is to read and understand. In practice, it works beautifully to flesh out the world. Jonathan Draper Carson, comics worth reading. Not many cartoonists can tell a compelling story without words, but Foran does it cleverly and with great deal of personality. Chris L. Eckman, Ninth Art. Rover is so far in a class with only a few other comics accessible to and enjoyable from for beginning readers and non-English speakers. This is a comic field too little explored. The mime tale, accessible to readers of all ages, a promising adventure. Comic buyer's guide. I agree. It was a promising adventure, and this thing really reminded me of Bone. Jeff Smith Bone. I really don't like doing the comparison in that sense, but the monsters especially. Okay, so I thought that was super cool. Super cool. Glad to have this. Wouldn't have had it if it wasn't for the comic book store dumping, getting rid of thousands of comics for like 25 cents a pop, right?